Welcome everybody. This is the physiotherapy part of our signposting information session for you. So the aim of physiotherapy is that we're part of the team for rheumatology, as you'll hear from all my other colleagues as well. The aim for us is that you can learn to look after yourself independently and also know that we're here to help you when you do need help. There are many methods we can use to help you, to help ease your pain, improve your quality of life, your range of movement, and then making all of these things more feasible to then achieve things like doing what we call activities of daily living. So your personal hygiene, your washing, your cooking, your cleaning, and then doing much more enjoyable things like going out, spending time and socialising with your family, and hopefully adding some exercise in there so that we can get your muscles and joints protected and strong and get your heart and lungs working to protect you from all the other horrible diseases such as heart attack, stroke and diabetes. When you come for physiotherapy, we will assess all of you, and then we can advise on specific joint problems and also about looking after all of yourself to achieve that quality of life. To get into physio, you can be referred by one of our consultants, by your GP, or you can always contact us on the rheumatology advice line, from where you're going to hear from the nurses later on in this programme. So you will be allocated a physiotherapy appointment time. During Corona, this will be on video or phone. Normally, it will be face-to-face. When you attend for your appointment, think of any questions prior to this appointment and write them down so you can remember them for when we ask you on the phone or face-to-face. Also, think of any goals, things that you can't do at the moment that you would really like to be doing, so we can work together to achieve those for you. And when you come, you'll need to be wearing loose clothing. What to do in a flare-up? A flare-up is when several of your joints become hot, painful, tender, and often swollen. You often feel more stiff in the morning, so it makes it harder for you to get going. One of the other important factors that often gets forgotten is fatigue or tiredness. So at this point in time, it's really important to balance how much you exercise or generally move around compared with how much you rest. So you need a period of relative rest at this time, but you need to put all of your joints through a good movement every day, so you're literally re-oiling them to prevent the stiffness. To assist you with this, we've also made another video about moving all your joints every day. So please have a look at this. It will take you approximately 10 minutes a day. Other things we can do then are, have a say, having relative rest and also relaxation, which is important, and my occupational therapy colleagues can teach you more about this. Important as well is looking after your joints and keeping them in a good position. So good posture is about putting your muscles, joints and ligaments in the optimum position. The optimum position means that the muscles can work most effectively and the muscle and joints in a relaxed position, so they work more efficiently for you and therefore use less energy and less pain. One of the ways of getting better posture in your hands is using splints and gloves. And again, my occupational therapy colleagues will give you more detail. For our feet, we can see my orthotic colleagues who can also put things inside your feet. And if your feet are in a good position, that will automatically make your hips and knees improve their position and help with pain as well. When you're sitting, you can look at the guidelines on websites for workplace positioning or health and safety guidelines. And there are numerous ones of these available, most of them saying exactly the same information. Some very simple things you can do are try using things such as a lumbar support, of which we have a little selection here today. This one is from a company called McKenzie, and there are many companies available. This is a super or flat roll, and it goes in your low back. So I'm going to place this at waistband level, and this is then going to lift me up so the top of me is stretched out and that arch or lumbar support there or lumbar spine is supported by this, making it much more comfortable and putting my neck and shoulders in a much better position as well. So there are numerous different companies available for these, and they come in various different diameters like this one as well. Personally, this one is quite fat for me. I would need a smaller one to do the same job, as this one makes me feel slightly pushed out. So please always try things out before you buy them if you can do. You can literally go Blue Peter style as well, and you can roll up a towel. Our NHS ones are a little bit threadbare. You can roll up a towel and then make it so it's probably a little bit fatter than this, and then pop it in your low back and it will do exactly the same thing. So this is when you're sitting at your desk, in your armchair, and also driving. It can really make a difference on long journeys for making you feel much more comfortable. At night, you want to make sure that your neck is supported. So the pillow should fill the gap from ear to shoulder if you lie on your side. That means if your pillow is too high, it will stretch all the muscles and ligaments on this side. If it's too low, it will stretch all the muscle and ligaments on this side. And the way they will tell you that is by giving you more pain. By getting your posture right, you will therefore help ease your pain quite drastically. So we've got your pillows from ear to shoulder. Then you go back to your rolled up towel, and this is probably about the right width, so it's about hand towel or medium bath towel. And then you roll it up, pop it inside your pillowcase so it doesn't roam around in the bed at night. So it fills that little gap from ear to neck there for you so that you can rest there gently. If you lie on your back, having the rolled up towel will support that little hollow in the back of your neck. So again, it's inside the pillowcase supporting you there. And that's a lovely, very simple yet very effective way of helping to control neck pain at night and make it feel better in the daytime as well. So posture in all our joints, be it with orthotics in our shoes, our sitting or lying, is really important for us and can help control pain. Some of the other ways we can help control pain are using things like ice. So we normally say if your joints are hot or swollen, go for ice. So a bag of frozen peas wrapped in a wet towel so you don't get an ice burn. And then on hands and fingers, 5-10 minutes. Big things like knees and shoulders, 10-15 minutes. Again, checking your skin to make sure you don't burn yourself. If you feel more stiff and achy, then wheat bags like this are lovely. They can go in the microwave and or the freezer with some of them. Again, check your skin. This one is really nice because it can mold really nicely around necks and shoulders, and you can put it on any of your joints as you need to. You can also have wax baths that you can use for your hands. So it comes as a little bath about that big. You melt the wax, pop your hand in and out a few times, and it's really good for your skin. Then you can pull the wax off and then you can mold it, pinch it, again shown as some of the exercises that we're doing on the other video. So stiff and achy, go for heat, hot or swollen, go for cold. Okay, then what we need to do is keep our joints on the move, so that's in the other video. And on the video we've also shown you progressions, because if the muscles were stronger, the muscles would take the strain rather than the joint, and therefore that equals less pain in the joint. So when you flare up, you need to keep your joints just moving nice and gently. When you're not in flare and you're feeling quite good, then you can build on the muscle strength to make things much more stronger to protect the joints for the future. The government guidelines are you exercise for about 150 minutes a week, so approximately 5 times 30 minutes. 3 times 30 minutes of cardiovascular, so heart and lung exercise, where you become a little bit short of breath. And the other two sessions are exercise for strengthening or resistance, using things such as these resistance bands or weights, and also for your balance. Some of these exercises, especially for your hips and wrists and your back, are really important to keep your bone quality and strength up to help prevent you breaking bones when you get older as well. Also, lots of information on pain management, and you also had a video from Emily talking about the pharmaceutical side of this. There are other things such as a TENS machine, which you can get simply from many of the local pharmacies, that vary from about £10 up to about £200. At £200, you're really not getting a lot more machine for your money, so again, have a good look around before you buy. You should not use one if you have arrhythmia problems in your heart and you need to take care with epilepsy. And also, if you're pregnant, please check with your midwife first. But TENS stands for a transcutaneous electrical nerve stimulator, or TENS machine. These work by blocking the pain messages that come in from your limbs into your spinal cord, that normally go up to your brain and tell you that there's pain in this area, telling you to do something about it. The idea of the TENS is it blocks the message at the spinal cord, sending up to your brain a tingling kind of message, which you can adjust according to what suits you. You can use these for up to 24 hours. However, they can be either excellent or useless. A little bit like Marmite, they work very, very well, or they don't work at all for you. But unfortunately, you don't know until you try. So if you do have a friend with one, it's worth borrowing one to see if that can help work for you as well. We also have hydrotherapy here at Southmead, which can be a really good way of getting all the weight off your joints and being able to move, and again making your heart and lungs work. If you're in a lot of pain, hydrotherapy can be an excellent way to help ease the pain and gradually build your strength back up. However, there are many local pools around that have their water warmed up at different times of the day and can be very beneficial for you. And swimming is an ideal form of exercise for working your heart and lungs and your joints at the same time. The main thing is, if you start swimming, start off really quite gently, because you don't realise how much you've done until you get out the pool. As you've heard from some of my colleagues, we have the rheumatology advice line, so please do contact them if you have any queries, and they can get on hold of us as physiotherapists, or again, please get referred in to have your own individual assessment and treatment as required. For ongoing support and self-maintenance, we have our support group, in which you're going to also hear from Liz. This is really important for helping you maintain yourself long term and having other people around you to help chat to and swap ideas with. Many people have found this extremely beneficial, so hopefully you'll enjoy the presentation from Liz as well.